Chaco Canyon is one of the best-known archaeological sites in the American Southwest. Constructed by the ancestral Puebloan people, often known as the Anasazi, this site is famous for its distinctive architecture. The pre-planned dwellings which define the site, known as great houses, are made up of many connected rooms and kivas, circular structures with semi-subterranean chambers used for ceremonial purposes. Less well known to the general public, but a point of fascination for many archaeologists, is how this architecture demonstrates an intricate knowledge of the astronomical cycles visible in the night sky. In fact, many archaeological findings from Chaco Canyon and the surrounding region suggest that astronomical observations were an integral part of ancestral Puebloan life. While human habitation of the area around Chaco Canyon can be dated back at least 9,500 years, the clearest archaeoastronomical significance is seen in findings from between 850 and 1250 CE, when the canyon was inhabited by the ancestral Puebloans. As this culture lacked written records, it would be easy to miss their astronomical knowledge, if not for the ways they incorporated their understanding of astronomy into many aspects of their society. While the impressive planning that took place in the settlements of Chaco Canyon is readily apparent, closer analysis reveals an important additional layer of meaning to this planning. The majority of Chacoan great houses possess certain features which demonstrate clear astronomical knowledge, from walls aligned with the cardinal directions or astronomical features, to windows and chambers designed to mark the approach and arrival of particular astronomical events by directing light in specific ways. Archaeological research has also rediscovered several of the manners in which ancestral Puebloans tracked astronomical cycles, including sites which seem to represent observatories, and a set of petroglyphs seemingly used to chart out solstices, equinoxes, and the lunar cycle, all based on patterns of light streaming through gaps in a row of well-placed stones. In this video, we'll discuss the archaeological indications of astronomical knowledge found throughout the ancestral Puebloan world. We'll further discuss sites which, based on their features and periods of habitation, indicate observation of the lunar cycle. Finally, we'll address the question of why these observations seem to have been so important to Chacoan culture, and some of the proposed cultural influences in their astronomical practices. In midsummer of 1977, artist Anna Sofair would make a major discovery while studying rock art in the southwestern U.S. as a field school volunteer. Atop Fajada Butte, a 400-foot-tall stone formation in the eastern part of Chaco Canyon, Sofair found a pair of spiral-shaped petroglyphs positioned behind a trio of sandstone slabs. It was late in the day, and the lighting was bad for photos, so she returned the next day, close to noon, to get a better look. It was only a week from the summer solstice, and Sofair noted that the sun shining between the slabs formed a dagger of light, which appeared to bisect the larger spiral. The field of archaeoastronomy was new and controversial at the time. Only 12 years earlier had the first book suggesting an astronomical purpose for Stonehenge been published. However, continued study of the sun dagger made it difficult to dispute the intentionality of these alignments. Continued study of the Fajada Butte petroglyphs over the next few years would reveal a conspicuous pattern, as these sun daggers would land in specific places during major solar events. In addition to the bisection of the large spiral every summer solstice, it was found that on the equinoxes, one dagger would mark the right side of the larger spiral, and a second would appear on the center of the smaller spiral, and that on the winter solstice, two daggers would line up with the left and right sides of the larger spiral's perimeter. Perhaps more significantly, it was eventually discovered that the spiral shape was used to chart out the movement of the moon, as shadows would mark different positions along the 9.5 turns of the spiral over the course of this 18.6-year cycle. A petroglyph being used to accurately trace such a long-term cycle demonstrated extended astronomical observations, a conclusion which would only gain more credence with continued study of Chaco Canyon. The ancestral Puebloans also seem to have carried out some observations at sites farther from the core Chaco Canyon area. One such site was Chimney Rock, a pueblo built in an inhospitable mountainous region south of what is now Durango, Colorado. With poor soil ill-suited for farming, the ancestral Puebloans would have had little practical reason to establish themselves at this site. However, the site of Chimney Rock possesses a distinct natural feature that the Chacoans may have sought to exploit. Two natural pillars of stone stand alongside each other, with a small gap between them. From a certain point of view, the moon would appear to rise directly between these two pillars every lunar maximum, and the great kiva of the Chimney Rock Pueblo was constructed in the exact position to see this phenomenon, suggesting the possibility that this location was chosen as a lunar observatory. This identification of Chimney Rock as a Puebloan lunar observatory is supported by the dating of the site. Tree ring data from the Pueblo's Great Kiva shows two spikes of construction, one in 1076 and one in 1093, consecutive lunar maximum years. This suggests that these two instances of construction may have happened in congruence with two ritual observation events. The Chacoans may have first discovered the use of the chimney rock formations in 1057, returned to the site to construct the kiva there 18.6 years later, in 1076, and then expanded the site 18.6 years after that, in 1093. However, they would not return the next lunar maximum. By that time, the Chacoan civilization had declined, and the people had moved from great houses into enigmatic cliff dwellings, seemingly abandoning many of their astronomical practices in the process. Over the course of the 80s and 90s, it became apparent that architecture throughout Chaco Canyon and the surrounding region was built in alignment with astronomical features. Out of 14 surveyed great house complexes, both inside of the canyon and on its periphery, 12 were found to have astronomical alignments. Of these, some alignments are based on the cardinal directions, such as Pueblo Bonito, which is divided into two symmetrical halves by a north-south dividing wall, and possesses a front wall oriented in the east-west direction. The pueblos of Tzinkletzin and Pueblo Alto, positioned on the canyon rims above Pueblo Bonito, possess a similar east-west alignment in their front walls, as well as an even more remarkable north-south alignment with each other, despite being 2 miles apart in distance. This same north-south alignment also connects the two to the Great Kiva of Casa Rinconada, a particularly interesting example of cardinal alignments in Chacoan architecture. The kiva possesses two doorways positioned to the north and south respectively, and four central pillars marking each of the four cardinal directions. In order to find all of these cardinal directions without the use of compasses, the Chacoans most likely used astronomy. Tracking the movement of the sun during the equinoxes would have shown them east and west. While observing the movements of the stars over the course of the year, they would have been able to see them pivot around the North Pole. The four cardinal directions remain culturally significant in the American Southwest to this day. In Southwestern culture, these directions are commonly associated with specific colors, stages of life, and culture heroes such as the white painted woman. Even the method of placing four pillars to represent the four directions, as seen in the Great Kiva of Casa Rinconada, is still present in some modern cultures of the Southwest. For example, the Apache and Navajo use four support beams arranged in such a fashion for ceremonial teepees. While the Apache and Navajo are not directly descended from the ancestral Puebloans, both were directly influenced by their Puebloan neighbors, making it possible that this cultural emphasis on directionality could reflect cultural continuity between the Chacoans and modern people of the Southwest. In addition to cardinal alignments, many buildings throughout Chaco Canyon align with astronomical events, including solstices and the lunar cycle. At Chaco Canyon's latitude, the sun can rise and set a maximum of 30 degrees removed from the east-west line at the solstices, known as the two annual solar standstill points, or solar maximum. The moon, meanwhile, can vary its alignment by another 6 degrees or so, reaching this distance of 36 degrees from the horizon once every 18.6 years, the lunar maximum. Every 9.3 years, meanwhile, the moon reaches its minimum point, 24 degrees removed from the horizon. Seven great houses in or proximal to Chaco Canyon show axial alignment to points on the lunar cycle, with five being aligned with the lunar minimum standstill on the horizon, and two with the lunar maximum standstill. The Chacoan great houses of Chetro Ketel, Kinkletzo, and Pueblo del Arroyo, and the outlying great houses of Pueblo Pintado and the Salmon Ruins, have all been found to possess primary axes within 2 degrees of the lunar minimum standstill. Una Vida and Penasco Blanco, two of the oldest great houses in Chaco Canyon, positioned at its west and east ends respectively, are the two great houses axially aligned to the lunar maximum standstill. Several great houses with cardinal alignments in their positioning or walls also show diagonal lunar alignments. For example, the previously discussed sites of Pueblo Alto and Tzinkletzo, in addition to aligning with each other on the north-south axis, have lunar minimum orientations from corner to corner of their rectangular chambers. A similar arrangement is also found at another great house, Hungo Pavi. As it exists today, the Casa Rinconada Kiva can be used to track the summer solstice, using an opening in the northeastern corner of the wall and a series of niches. Sunlight shines through the opening and, for 7 weeks prior to the summer solstice, gradually moves across the wall to strike a series of niches before reaching one specific niche on the solstice itself. However, some information casts doubt on the intentionality of this function. When the kiva was first discovered, it had accrued a substantial amount of damage to the northeast. The current reconstruction, therefore, may not accurately reflect the kiva's original form, and may thus present an unintentional astronomical function. Aside from Fajada Butte, This is the only known site at Chaco Canyon with a possible summer solstice alignment. However, many more sites possess apparent winter solstice alignments, which seem much more reliable than the possible alignment of Casa Rinconada. Throughout Chaco Canyon, there are a number of sites where certain features mark the winter solstice, such as Pueblo Bonito. Here, multiple windows are placed in corner positions where they would direct squares of light into the interior corners of their respective rooms each winter solstice. The sites of Huijiji and Quinclezo, meanwhile, provide viewing areas for niches on the southern canyon wall, which provide a 2-week early warning system for the coming of the winter solstice. Of these, Huijiji is particularly interesting, as it is perhaps the final great house built in Chaco Canyon, and additionally appears to have been used after the ancestral Puebloans had left. On the cliff face used to track the approach of the winter solstice, Navajo solar symbols rest alongside ancestral Puebloan ones, suggesting that later migrants to this region may have seen the significance of the site. From alignments with the cardinal directions, to petroglyphs and light displays which seem to reflect an intimate knowledge of the cycles of the sun and moon, Chaco Canyon is full of archaeological remains which point to the practice of astronomy amongst the ancestral Puebloans. Because this area lacks written records, our understanding of the topic is based almost entirely on archaeological findings, with no contribution from historical documents. On account of these limitations, and the relatively short period during which southwestern archaeoastronomy has been a subject of study, there are gaps in our knowledge, and what we do know hinges on the interpretation of different items. Many questions remain, chief among them why the ancestral Pueblos placed their focus on such astronomical observations at all, given the time and effort they would have required. One obvious suggestion may be that such observations were intended to help monitor the seasons for agriculture, but agriculture had been practiced in the Southwest since long before we see any evidence of complex astronomy, and such a possibility would only explain a few facets of Chacoan astronomy. The north-south orientation of many archaeological sites may relate to the modern Pueblo perception of the north as a place from which souls originate and to which the dead return. The modern Pueblo further practice rituals honoring the sun and moon on certain important days, which may reflect the Chacoans' reason for constructing sites to mark certain points on lunar and solar cycles. Beyond spiritual explanations, it's possible that such sites were intended to help maintain a common calendar across a decentralized and dispersed community, so that they could better coordinate for shared events. Whether any, all, or none of these possibilities explain Chacoan astronomy, we may never know. However, given the youth of the field, there remains a great range of possibilities for further discoveries, and many mysteries may be solved with continued research into this enigmatic subject. Thanks for watching, everybody. I've been Soma, and please like and subscribe for more videos in the future.